Greetings, hi, the War Owl greets you, and it's time for game number two between Cloud9 and the Ninjas in Pyjamas. This is game number two of this best of three series from ESL One Cologne between these two great teams. Game number one did go to Cloud9 in quite the upset. Okay, Faflaren here set up to throw the smoke. This map, Terra-sided, is probably going to favor Cloud9, considering the times that they played against the Ninjas in Pyjamas on this map before were the ones that Cloud9 was able to win. And we see nothing. Watching short right now. Jumping CZ OP first round. Oh, but Freiburg is going to pick him. Excellent. And it looks like now we have Ninjas in Pyjamas setting up to do a split at bombsite B. We have players waiting outside long. And then we have players at short as well. And here is Faflaren. Entry frag machine. Switching out with Exist to take out Shroud and check it out. It's just Hiko left. 1 versus 5. Excellent job by Freiburg taking that short position. Perfect execution of the pistol strat here. By Ninjas in Pyjamas just has to deal with the straggler, Hiko, the clutch king. And get right around the side, and there it is, folks! You wanted to see it again, it is the Hiko shot, as he does a ridiculous flick shot to take out Get Right. It looks like hacks, but it is not. It is just Hiko and his ridiculously high sensitivity. Creeping up on Faflaren here. 1 versus 3. And not much that he can really do in this situation here, but he is going for it. And Hiko does go down by Exist's hand. What an excellent start there. And we see Get Right type the nice shot. And wasn't it, though? It was a shot heard around the world where a North American team could show that they could kill Get Right. All right, and yes, that is true. I've seen this game already, but you guys wanted this series cast, so here it is now, going up on the YouTubes. Second round, Ninjas in Pyjamas will be able to purchase these guns and armor. We have a full CZ buy here from Cloud9. And here's Hiko holding off bombsite B. Zemph is there as well, so two players B. Cloud9 playing a very safe strategy where they're holding the rush positions with these pistols, so we have two players watching at long A. This is actually really smart, and I like this. The exposed area right now is short A. We see Gares moving back to try to get intel to see if they're already in bombsite A. You can see him checking the corner there in case they're walking. Knows they're not there, and they're going to be pushing out middle, so it's nothing around the corner with the CZ. Exists sort of peeking it. Flashback. Tentatively. Terrorist getting ready to charge into bombsite A now, going short. They've figured out the weak point. CT's already rotating. This is really smart. They got three players at mid, looking like they want to power through and get behind these terraces as they push short. But that's not going to happen. It's all up to Gares. 1 versus 5. Now, there's no armor bought. This isn't really a round they expect to win. And Cloud9 definitely wants to do as much damage as possible. All three of them standing inside a pit right now. That's dangerous as the terrorists surround them, mow them down. There's Freiburg with the shot, and oh my gosh, Get Right completely trolling poor defenseless Shroud walking behind him. That was crazy. Now, the reason for doing that, which is, I mean, it's funny to watch, right? But the reason for doing that is they don't know where the last player is. Let's just, okay, Get Right was trolling him, let's be honest here. Third round, and Cloud9 is going to do a strange force buy where we have a scout here on Gares, goodness. This kind of a strategy, probably not going to work. In the meantime, Ninjas in Pyjamas. Three players inside of the tunnels. Get Right with the P90. Goodness. The Get Right 90. And we have Shroud watching from pit here. They've rotated nothing back to watch short. So standard setup here. Terrorists got that bomb back. Looking like they're just going to be going for those picks, trying to get intel at this point. Nothing too crazy. What? Gares taking a player down through middle with this scout. He does get put down to 15 health. And that sort of evens it up here for this force buy by Cloud9. Now, Terrace are at middle, looking like they want to creep over to bombsite A. Now, this is a risky buy strategy. Oh, look at this. Terrace actually going to be pushing through mid. The smoke for mid to B. No, this is a... it's a trap. I think they're going to be going short with this. Bomb has been picked up. Terrorists now setting up to go short. Here's Semphis in position to deal with this. Nothing has rotated over here as well. And Terrorists pushing. One player at long. Semphis holding out the corner. Player at long has fallen back. Terrorists rotating. Counter Terrorists actually giving them this position. So they've counted. They know they have three players. Hiko's got the intel. You gotta be looking for this Lurk player at this point. And there it is. It is Flaren up there. Looking like he's going to catch Gares off guard, and yes, he will. Oh my, Counterterra is trying to push in. Shroud with two excellent headshots through the smoke. Flaren not in position. Freiburg trying to hold off that bomb defuse. One versus two. Hiko gonna go for the defuse. Gotta push out here. This is where a plant for short would come in handy, but this is pre-patch for that. Hiko going for the defuse. Flaren engages. And Shroud and Hiko take him down with the Famuses. And guess what, guys? That is a crazy win from Cloud9. Oh, timer! So close there. They didn't even have kits. They did that force buy without kits. That is insane. But Shroud with a three frag. Showing his worth, proving his worth here on DE Dust 2. All right, so that's a steal. That was a round that should have gone to Cloud9. Generally, the meta is second round armor pistol, CT side. It's not something you would do very often on Dust 2 in particular, though. Not a map where you would do that. So third round force buy with Famuses is quite strange. However, it was able to work. It was successful. I haven't actually seen that before in a professional tournament. Until this point. Alright, but it is going to be another buy round here from Cloud9 due to them winning the previous round. Ninjas in Pyjamas still has money to buy as well. Now keep in mind on the UI, that glitch is still going on where I can't see all of the nades that they have. Alright, Gares and Nothing holding this off very aggressively. Going to be punished for that as poor Gares tries to slip away. Ain't going to happen. A bullet just slipped through his eyelid into his brain. Terra is now pushing forward. Trying to take short A. Here's the bomb on Flaren, engaging Goose. Ooh, but he'll go down to a duck shot. Now just Hiko left, one versus two, but get right from behind. Perfectly taps him. Now we saw in the last game there on Nuke, get right was having some serious trouble killing Hiko. Looks like that's been corrected because he just one-tapped poor Hiko in the back of his head. And I think that little rivalry between the friendly, they're not angry, right? They like each other. Between get right and Hiko will continue here. Those players tend to have the same role, and they tend to meet each other a lot on the battlefield, so it's a lot of fun to watch those two players playing in the same game. Get right to end Hiko. Tempest, you're insane! Tries to go for the one dig out middle. That peak was ridiculous. Well, he didn't get the shot, but he did survive, which is surprising. Freiburg definitely looking for that, like, come on, peek me. What are you thinking? Exist moves out as well. Exist is really good at playing this mid position on T side. He can get the picks out of there quickly around the corner and that sort of thing. And we'll see when he gets on the CT side, he tends to play the CT spawn. So kind of the same place on the map as this. All right, keep in mind it is a save round after Ninjas in Pyjamas gets back into this thing. Shroud at long now for Flaren just holding down the position. It's always good to keep a player there just in case. Terra's pushing at short. Freiburg trying to entry frag. Where is Exist to take his place? No? I guess they're falling back, and they will be smoking and taking bomb site B, which is the right call, because guess what? There ain't nobody there inside of bomb site B here. No terrorists. There are no counter terrorists. Oh, it's just Shroud left. Instead, they move up short and just pick him. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Freiburg and Exist. Best friends for life. Ninjas in Pyjamas at 4. Points now against Cloud9's 1. And check this out. Poor Semphis sitting at 0 frags so far in this game. Oh my. Alright. 4 is going to be holding down the mid-aught position. Counts that 2 cross because there was no smoke for that. Didn't try to go for the shot. What an ugly skin. That Dragon Lore. Oh, smoke is down. Now he doesn't have intel. He doesn't know how many. And two-player hold off again at long A. This is pretty cool. I like this. Terrorists at middle right now. Smoking it down, taking their time. Looking like they're going short again. They've been exposing this short position repeatedly. That's been getting them the points. Let's see if they can do it this time. Freiburg has been doing an absolutely excellent job here. Entry fragging on short A. Smoke is down to allow him to cross. Not going to do it, though. This is to try and bait these players to rotate. They're not going to rotate. T's setting up for an A-side take. They're going to push through long. And right now, Cloud9's aggressive hold-off is going to benefit them. But Gares makes a bunch of noise, so we can't be sneaky-beaky-like. But we have Shroud and Gares to hold this off. Shroud's going to engage first, it looks like. Then Gares from around the corner. Flashes out. Shroud engages. Now it's time for Gares. Oh, he missed the shot, though, and Flaherin sneaks by somehow. Flaherin at long A, running into the site to help Freiburg now, and guess what? Terrace have it, but oh, there's still two players. Pit! Forrest with the flank. Oh, Freiburg all alone there. Runs out of bullets. It's never a good sign. And Forrest somehow grabs the bomb, egresses, hops on over to bomb site B. We'll be planting that thing, and counter terrorists are left scratching their head like, how did that happen, guys? They now have to rotate and take this off. Forrest got to hold it off. 1v3, not easy. Two players low. How much ammo does he have in that CZ? He really probably wants to use the CZ in this situation if he can pick nothing. Well, he's got the CZ now, and it's full. Fully loaded. Jumping CZs! Forrest likes to jump and pistol. I guess that's his thing. Five rounds in that thing, and nothing will spray him down. But does he have time to defuse that bomb? That's going to be a no, because he doesn't have a kit. Where is he running? And nothing. Grabbing the AWP on the... Ooh, no, he's not. It's Cloud9 deciding not to AWP on CT side. May have been a mistake. I don't know. Intentional? Question mark? And that round will go to Ninjas and Pyjamas, despite all of them being dead. All right, Ninjas and Pyjamas at 5 points against Cloud9's 1. We'll be buying up. Poor Cloud9 will have to save. So nothing will survive here. Armor, no helmet. No helmet is fine, because these are AK-47s. It's a one-tap. Flaherin watching middle, just getting that intel. Three players moving into lower tunnels here to hold mid. Get right watching it, just in case a player decides to peek. Symphys, you are a crazy man. Symphys peeking once again aggressively. Could catch Get Right off guard if he pushes now. No, Get Right's now watching it. Aware of what's going on. Symphys, sneaky beaky-like. Hiko's joining forces here. They're going to try and trade on to Get Right. Let's see if they can do it. They don't know if the player is here or not. We see Hiko setting up for the shot, though, in case there is a player up on top of the heating box. And, ooh, wanted to peek. There's Symphys. Takes him down. There's the trade. So they do get the trade off of Get Right. That's nice. Hiko falls back into the site. He only has 14 health left, though. Terrorists. Still at that mid control. 45 seconds left. Gare's up close. Will these terrorists try to push out? No, they're going to be going B. This is smart. So they lost a player over here. They knew there was one playing here. They fell back because they assumed. They said, okay, Cloud9 is going to think we're going A because of that. They faked A. They've had that flash by Flaherin as well as Short. Continue to make him think something was going on. Let's watch how they check the different spots. Forrest goes in there. Freiburg checks the left corner. They go at cross. Nobody checked the back of sight yet. Freiburg checks it, and then they have the sight. Love how they do that. You have to take a site like fire. And what I mean is you have to move in really quickly and just check everywhere there's oxygen. Everywhere someone could be living. Flashback. All right, we see two AK-47s picked up. One on Hiko, one on nothing. They may want to save those things. In the meantime, Shroud and Gares have nothing to live for. They're going to try and hold the terrorists in the site and go for the exit frags. However, they now have a path to safety. So it is poor Shroud. I think the terrorists are all going to exit through the tunnels, though. Shroud continuing to try to shoot them. And we'll be saving his 5-7? No, he blows up and dies. All right. And Cloud9, on an eco, fragged one player and stole an AK. Not very useful, not bad. All right, Ninjas in Pyjamas now at 6 points. Definitely leading against Cloud9. However, once the tables have turned, Cloud9 has a very strong terrorist side on this map, and Ninjas in Pyjamas tends to struggle with the CT side on this map in particular. Symphys peeking up the middle! Again with the crazy picks, this time it did work, and Flaherin is dead. Oh, what? Forrest through the smoke, perfectly one-taps poor Hiko. This is crazy. And Get Right. From middle now, sneaking up on nothing. And they take him on two different positions. Forrest at one health left. Two players here, Gares and Shroud. Shroud trying to shoot through that smoke. There's nobody there. And looking like Cloud9 is going to try and save again. Now, the rotates from Cloud9 have been a little bit bad. They've left much to be desired. They have not been in a position to retake bombsite B yet. They've always had to exit and save, and that is losing points. If they can put it into a sort of a 3v3 for the retake on bombsite B when they're close as the bomb goes down, they have a chance. Oh my. Now just Shroud left, grabbing that AWP to save it. Get right. AWPing out of, shooting him, one-tapping out of nowhere. Shroud misses the shot. Terra's pushing in. Will he survive? And he takes out Get Right. Whoa! Accidentally no-scopes a AK at the player. It scares him off. Good thing. All right, Cloud9 actually does want to AWP here on CT side nuke. So nothing not grabbing that AWP before must have been a mistake. So we have Garrus and Sempus both going to be AWPing. Sempus at middle. We know he's going to go for this. And he gets it. Picks off Forest. It says it's through a wall, but it was actually through that light thing. Very nice. Where is Garrus? My goodness. He pushes out behind the box at middle, watching for lower. Get Right is going to peek that. Let's see if he gets this pick. Oh, just misses it. Needs to fall back. Double AWP mid. This is crazy. Smoke goes down, but Sempus can still watch short. Since it wasn't an Xbox smoke. Get Right. Through the smoke. Taps Sempus. Takes him down to 3 health. Very nice. Alright. Terra's now pushing out at long. Got two players to deal with here. Flaren flashing in. Will go down. Flaren down as well. Leaves Exist alive, and Exist cleans up the place. It is just Get Right left, though. That was not a good trade at long. And this looks like a round here for Ninjas in Pyjamas, and Get Right, you're not going to be able to shoot accurately when you jump over the side. Perplexing move there, and Hiko cleans it up. All right, Ninjas in Pyjamas at 7 points, Cloud9 at 2. Again, continuing with this double AWP CT side, coming off of a win here, which is very nice for them, on this CT side. All right, smoke's over. This is to make it easier to take this position. It's a very nice smoke for terrorists to throw. This gives long control here to these terrorists. If they were to stay or try to cross because of that smoke, they get killed. Now poor Shroud. He's got to hold off the Al. Remember the Alamo here at long A at car. Does kill a player and take bomb control. This is huge. Freiburg runs out short and goes down. It's just Fiflaren left, and he's dead. Good round from Cloud9. That was crazy. It looked like Ninjas in Pyjamas had the advantage there as they pushed out and took long A and traded for that position. But the players at short got mowed down, so the A split didn't work. Okay, Cloud9 starting to come back. Gets 2 points in a row. Have to feel good about that. Sempus continuing to go for the shot. Knows that he jumped down into the fast cat lane. That's a smoke will definitely save his life. Terra's taken lower so that they can watch short. Now have position at middle. Definitely taking their time setting this up, trying to get the intel. They have been able to take Cloud9 on A site takes pretty well, as well as the B site takes. They've generally been able to take B once Cloud9 rotates out of it. Cloud9 being very liberal with their rotates. Something that we don't see a lot from Ninjas in Pyjamas, who stay very stoically in one spot. Don't fall for tells. Now, Cloud9's rotates, they've been rotating out of B a lot. However, they haven't been rotating to B a lot. If you understand what I mean. When terrorists are taking B, they don't rotate well enough to take care of it. However, when terrorists are taking bombsite A here, different story. All right. Garrus gets shot. Down to 54. Terrace in the sight. Freiburg watching the back. Nice shot. Doesn't know about Hiko, though. Hiko is still up here. Oh, Garrus takes him out. Garrus with another shot with the CZ, and that's the defuse. Nice job from Garrus. 2 CZ entry frags into that bomb site. Now, a lot of what we see from the Ninjas in Pyjamas is taking positions, giving players away, and setting up specific players for frags. So the high frag players are generally going to be... if we check out their scoreboard, we see Freiburg and Exist really high. Freiburg with the entry frags, Exist is the one they sort of set up for the frags. Forest is kind of the guy they set up for the frags. Yeah, Freiburg honestly is playing really well because his job is not... to get those frags. It's really to get a frag, maybe trade, but just use him to take positions. Cloud9 having some trouble dealing with this. Sempfis again, with an aggressive angle here. Terrace creeping out middle. Where's the mid to B smoke? They are saving on this round. Get right in Freiburg with guns. Get right uses the opportunity of Gare's AWPing to sneak out. Shroud takes him down. Forest finds Sempfis's AWP. Remember, he was aggressively peeking? This is the disadvantage to that. Now Forest has an AWP. He's alive, and he just killed two of your buddies. So nice job, Sempfis. You just got him killed. All right, Forrest has got an ace for the win with no armor AWP that he scavenged from the corpse of his fallen foe. Charging through his own smoke. What a player. Bomb is down. Forrest is going for it. Bunny hopping all over. But Gare's with a four frag. Let's get an owl vision. No, that's... never mind. Those were saving players. Let's not. And Forrest is insane, pretty much. So what I was talking about there with the aggressive peeking is we had the player here at short. If a player sneaks up on him, takes that AWP, has nobody there to trade with him, you've just given a saving player an AWP. That is a huge money loss. You give them an AWP and you lose an AWP. Whole lot of money. And of course, two players died along with that, so you have to factor in their equipment as well. Cloud9 coming back into this thing, now at 5 points. Ninjas in Pyjamas starting to lose their groove. Seems like Cloud9 has figured out how to deal with Ninjas in Pyjamas' aggression. They've slowed down a bit, too. Right now, a short take would work really well here for Ninjas in Pyjamas because Cloud9 has rotated their players over to B. That smoke there, preventing Ninjas in Pyjamas from pushing, which is very smart. Shroud just watching this spot. They should rotate nothing over here once that smoke clears. He's throwing a Molotov as well. However, it is immediately extinguished. In the meantime, Terrace push out middle. Are going to be taking B, and now is the time where Cloud9 tends to save. Because look, Shroud's way over here. Gare's could not be further away. And they're not going to be able to retake B. They just don't have the time. And they especially don't have the numbers now. 2v5. Okay. Ninjas in Pyjamas aware of this, sending out a hit squad to take these players down. So Shroud and Gare is going to set up camp at long A. Here's Exist trying to peek. You know, Shroud is in the pit. Oh, that's such a difficult shot to hit. You have to perfectly one-tap. And even at that distance, AK is not going to be perfectly precise on the shot. Ooh. Trying to catch Gare's off guard. Freiburg moves in and does his job with the entry fragging. And there's the trade for Forest kill. Looking good. Cloud9, 2 rounds left. We'll be able to buy on this round and drop. There he goes. Can still win this thing. Using all their money on this round, this is like, we win this, we win 2 points. Well, no, Ninjas in Pyjamas should be able to buy next round as well. But if Cloud9 loses this, they're going to have to do a crazy force buy in the next round. Sempfis! Try to go for an aggressive peek at middle. Not going to happen. Three-player hold off at long. They'll start to rotate players back now. Or they'll charge forward. That works too. Look at where Fiflaren is. Fiflaren is the player to watch for long aggression. You generally only have them there as a formality. Because you don't expect players to push through long. You just want to make sure they can't. Well, Gare's was a little bit slow on that. Like, delayed reaction. I think he was trying to go for him if he moved back to peek it. Through that door. Fiflaren falls back to hold this position. Look at this. Sempfis. Ooh, trying to go for the headshot on Get Right. Runs into a nade. Shroud waiting. Fiflaren waiting. The waiting game. In the meantime, Terrace are going to try and push at short A. Nope, they've fallen back from that. Looking like they were testing the waters here with Freiburg, who's been doing an excellent job here. Two players holding that off. That's not where they want to go. They don't know that, though. They don't have the intel for that. Well, flashing over the top. Two players here at middle, none in B. This is the time for Ninjas in Pyjamas to go back and take bombsite B, and that's exactly what they're going to be doing. Nobody really watching this. Three players creeping out here. Going to be taking this site. Where are the counter terrorists? They're right outside the door. Oh, Hiko goes down, though. Nothing kills a player on the cross. That's really nice. Get Right being aggressive. Sempfis takes out Get Right through that box. Just Exist left. And there's a trade. Nothing will defuse that bomb and get the trade. And Cloud9 is still in this game, putting themselves at 6 points. One more round in the half, and if Cloud9 is able to win it, it'll be pretty much even. This is a slightly T-sided map. However, I think that is gonna favor Cloud9 in the long run on this, because Ninjas in Pyjamas, once Cloud9 gets the T and Ninja Pyjamas gets a CT, things change a bit. We've seen these two teams go up against each other multiple times in major tournaments. Generally, what happens is Ninjas in Pyjamas knocks out Cloud9. In one instance, Cloud9 knocked out Ninjas in Pyjamas into the lower brackets of the ESEA. That was on Cloud9's home turf. But yeah, these two teams definitely play against each other a lot. They always get matched up against each other in like the quarterfinals or the semifinals. Never in the finals. I'm waiting for that to happen. Then we'd see some good games. Alright, Forrest gets picked. We have Gares from Goose. Terrorists creeping up. Going to be pushing short, so it is up to Gares to hold off this push by the Ninjas in Pyjamas. And will he get smoked off? No, he won't. He'll get flashbacked, though, and he legs a player as he jumps by. Hits him right in the boot. Nice. Nice. Not nice, and he does go down. However, this opens it up for Cloud9. They've already rotated into position. Oh, just get right left. He's got a player behind him sneaking up. Gonna be trying to push forward. And nothing. We'll get the final frag. And that is gonna be it for the half. We shall resume when these teams are ready for the second half. Check out Shroud there at 19-8. What a score. Goodness. Second half will be commencing here. It's all pretty much tied up. Ninjas in Pyjamas able to take 8 points. T-side does too. That's very standard. Cloud9 now taking the T-side reins. Let's see how they manage here on this pistol round. Now, Ninjas in Pyjamas has come up against these guys numerous times in this situation. They've always been outdone. The reason being, Cloud9 is so aggressive. Let's see if Ninjas in Pyjamas figure out what's going on at this point. Oh, nothing with a peek. A pick down middle. Exists there as well. Terra's going to be pushing short now. And we do have Fufleurin to hold this off. One player still that long. Counter terrorists throwing that smoke here on first round. It's delaying them long enough. Counter terrorists not rotating just yet. They have some players. Should be shooting through middle to keep them from crossing. That pick off of Forest is huge for this round. Oh! Trying to get fancy with it, huh? Jumping down into, B, they're gonna lose a lot of health to do that silliness there. However, Terrace are able to take the site. Bomb is down, though. They left Hiko with the bomb solo inside of B tunnels. Ninjas in Pyjamas, aware of what the strategy was going on, as soon as they jumped over the side, said, let's push B and kill that bomb carrier. Because you're gonna keep the bomb carrier inside of the B tunnels like that. So that was so smart. Shroud pulling a get right and killing get right with the get right. And here is Gears. Oh, what? Wow, Exist. Okay, I want to get an owl vision on Exist's pistol shot there. That was intense. Bomb has been planted. The reason the player was jumping up like that was to get intel, to see where they were, call it to his teammates, and set up to hold him off. That was pretty crazy there. Did not expect to get shot midair like that. Oh, is it a brush? It isn't. It's an around the world. Who's watching middle? That's Freiburg. The smoke goes down. They could use this to go short, but Freiburg will catch him trying to do it. Because you can see over the top of this smoke. No, never mind. They'll sneak by one at a time. Two by two, two by two. The only one he did see was Hiko, who went the other way, the road less traveled. However, we have counter-terrorists setting up here inside of the site to hold them off. Fufleurin just with a pistol. I think that's so that he can purchase an AWP for a teammate or for himself. Just Hiko left now. It was a nice attempt at a strategy, and it's going to be destroyed. Now, Ninjas in Pyjamas, smart to keep three players here. Seemed to know what was going on. They didn't know that the players crept up there like that. I like the strategy, though. It's neat. You put the pistolers here inside of B tunnels, move lower, throw a smoke here, hop up so he can't, just barely can't see him, and push A. However, ninjas and pajamas need to be aware of it. I'm not really sure what the false tell is, though, on that. And it's going to be Faflaren AWPing. This is the only map where Faflaren does use the AWP. Generally, it's going to be Forest. And even then, Forest will AWP on this map as well. But Ninjas in Pajamas decides to use Faflaren as the AWPer. Alright, Cloud9 taking mid control. Working on short. Symphys is up there all by himself, though. Alright, Shroud going to be moving in to trade if Symphys goes down. We have Exist rotating over here into CT spawn, just in case they try to go short. And Faflaren holding it off in this very strong AWP angle. I really like this angle. He has a player at long, so they can't take him there. Cloud9 setting up for the split. Three short, two long. Faflaren with the pick. Terrorist now pushing, but he's abandoned his post. That will allow Terrorist to take the site. Different position, because you cannot plant short in this, remember. Oh, Gears will just plant it behind that box in the safe plant position. If he had tried to push out, I think Faflaren would have taken him down. Counter Terrorist moving to retake this. Get right, take some time to get more bullets. And Exist with a 3-frag. Just Hiko left again. Hiko has not been able to clutch in this game just yet, and he goes down. Bomb has been defused, and it's 7-11 now in favor of the Ninjas in Pajamas. Good round all around for the Ninjas in Pajamas on that. Cloud9 was able to take the site. Ninjas in Pajamas, you saw that rotate, and they set up to retake it pretty quickly. That was a pretty cool round. As we saw Cloud9 move in here short to take A, and we had two players pushing here from long. Just a standard split A. They let them have the site. Faflaren, watch this position. They actually have two players watching this. They picked off one. Then just let them have it, let them plant the bomb. Then we had players from CT move in at the same time as they had Faflaren here. I liked it. Alright, Faflaren now watching middle with this thing. It is a force buy from Cloud9. They have a bunch of Galils. Who is watching short? That'll be nobody. Terrorists getting ready to push. Oh, they've smoked it off once again. There's a smoke for CT. That says we're jumping over the side into B. Oh, Exist thought it was going to happen, but it didn't. Terrace instead going to be pushing into short. Took their time, though, and allowed Zis to set up and take those frags. Hiko playing the lurk. Shroud still moving into the site. Counter Terrace watching long. They're like, where are the rest of these guys? Both of them are at short, though, and Shroud should be able to plant this bomb. Ooh, engaged Faflaren the AWPer. You have the bomb, Shroud. You have the bomb. Get right sneaking up on him now. Hiko watching CT, watching every position. Get right will take him down with an excellent shot. Didn't even see him. Freiburg with another one. Ninjas in Pajamas all of a sudden is now on. Their shots are landing. Landing like Neil Armstrong on the moon. All right, Cloud9, 7 points only. They have not been able to take a single point here on this half, and they will be saving on this round. Oh, it's an aggressive push at long A. There's the pre-nade. Pre-nade hits nobody. Nice. Terrorists sort of sneak by it there. Exist left behind to mow these players down. Forced to pull out the pistol. Ooh, there's picks happening. Man, here's nothing. Taking on Faflaren and CT. And get right, holding down the angle, we'll take him down. Ninjas in Pajamas, 13 points now. Cloud9 at 7. Not able to make anything happen here on T-side, and Ninjas in Pajamas getting closer to pushing this into a game number 3. What can they do? They have to switch up their strategy. Symphys going to be AWPing here for the first time on T-side Dust2. Watching middle, let's see if he can get the pick off of Faflaren. That's a smoke so they can cross without any intel. So they don't know how many went across. Shroud moving down here to take short. Cloud9 has been getting demolished every time they try to take short A. Ninjas in Pajamas rotating really, really well there. They're going to have to try and trick them. They're going to have to try and say, we're going short and then go B. Alright. Forest gonna Molotov them if they decide to push. Semphis gets the pick. Over here at B. On exist. Freiburg's still up there. Forest moves back to watch middle. Smoke mid to B has been thrown. That was an aggressive peek. Get right. At long. Here's the player outside. Terrasar gonna be going mid to B, so here's Freiburg to hold it off. And they need to check the spot. Gares jumps up and sees it. Will be trading. That's good. That's exactly what they wanted to do. And now it is just get right left. One versus four. That was an excellent round from Cloud9. They are definitely back in this thing. That was the round that they needed. A confidence boost. They figured out what was going on with Ninjas in Pyjamas. They tricked them, and they did go B. So Get Right is going to play exits. Trying to save for the next round. Doesn't have any intel about where these guys are. Flashback. Well, now he does. And he will survive. Semphis could get picked here. And there he goes. No terrorist in a position to kill him, though. Terrorists win. Not going to stop Hiko from trying. Did no! Almost had enough time. And that's 8 points to 13 now. Cloud9 able to hold on to this game here. Looking like it was slipping away from them. But now it's time to make the comeback. To start getting some rounds on T-side. A few minor mistakes there from Ninjas in Pyjamas, though. Allowed them to do that. Gears, you can't hear it, apparently. But he is going to be auto-snipering, spamming the door. It hits nothing. Well, it doesn't hit anybody. Let's say it that way, so we don't get confused about Sir Nothing here. Alright. Terrace looking like they want to do a split A. This hasn't worked yet. They've tried this a number of times. It's always gone south. Let's see if it'll work this time. Half position there. Flaren watching the corner. With the AWP. That's an odd place to watch as an AWP. Well, he's playing from Goose. Which don't usually watch the corner here. We'll get intel if they decide to push. They can easily flash him out, though. And force him back into Goose. Which leaves him exposed when they push up. Ooh, they are so taking their time. About to commence here with the attack. And here it goes. Flashes up. Hits for Flaren and forces him back into Goose. This is working. They've just Molotov a player into pit. Exist moving into the fishbowl there. Oh, Flaren kills a player at long. CT's half long. They will get this bomb planted. That is going to be Gid right here inside of the pit. Grabs the auto sniper. And sprays a player down. Here comes Forrest from short. Needs to move a little bit faster here. Two versus two. Nothing in Shroud on the site. Gid right and Forrest. Gid right now grabs an AK and is moving in close. Timer ticking down. Forrest sneaks up from behind. Now just Shroud left. One versus two to hold off Gid right. And Forrest, nice pick. One taps Forrest as he's charging forward. And takes out Get Right as well. Excellent round from Shroud. Giving Cloud9 the point they most desperately needed. Wow, Shroud now at 25 frags. That's massive. Exist at 24. Right behind. Alright. Cloud9 has to keep winning here. Let's see if they can keep it up. This round will be a save round from the Ninjas in Pyjamas, just pistols. See how they play these corners. Well, they're keeping a few players at middle, or in CT spawn, just in case they try to move out and do a mid to B. Ninjas in Pyjamas is set up for a, if Cloud9 does mid to B, they dead. If they go A, we got nothing to do. And look at this, Cloud9 will be pushing out here. That's short A. All of them. CTs are down there in that smoke. Poor guys. Oh, let's see if this boost will work. If they'll be able to get a shot with this. Nope, they got discovered and mowed down. Poor guys. Get right inside of the pit still. Nothing really much that Ninjas in Pyjamas can do in this situation. Cloud9 takes it. Easy peasy. And Forrest trades himself. That's all I really could do in that situation. It's for Flaren. One versus four. USP. No reason to live. Let's see if he can take a gun and get out, maybe. Looking for something. All right, I guess it's easy. Why not? And he survives. He'll try and pick these players at long, but he won't have a lot of time. Oh, he gets the AK! Okay, that's good. That's actually really good. So he stole an AK. They will have money to buy this round. And Cloud9 is catching up in the points after winning a few T-sides in a row. That's huge. Simph is bringing the AWP over B-side. Gear's getting stuck here. Waiting for the smoke. So this is to watch short, but check it out. Ninjas in Pyjamas have not played a player aggressively at short. They've generally played Flaren with an AWP, holding down these corners. And that's really what Cloud9 needs to abuse right now. Flashbang. They can throw a flash, then I'll force Flaren back at long A. Oh, look at this. Sempitz creeps out middle for an aggressive peek again, but that he will go down because of it. Terrorist pushing at short. Flaren does miss the shot. Is forced back. Terrorist can now take bomb site A. Their smoke is down, but it'll allow them to safe plant. That's going to be nothing with the bomb plant. And we have a 5 versus 4 retake. It's not very often you see this happen. A site taken without a CT dead. There's no reason Ninjas in Pyjamas shouldn't go for this. They've got everything they need to retake this. And here's Flaren with the AWP. Nothing takes him down. Get right still up. Players inside of CT. In the meantime, mowing down the players at short. And a swarm of counter-terrorists pushes up the ramp. Here's Hiko, 1 versus 2. Oh, Get Right defuses that bomb. Just barely able to get it. Wow, what a retake. Get Right at 7 points, Exist at 10, taking a 3 frag. He's now at 27 frags, just now surpassing Shroud. And that puts Ninjas in Pyjamas at that critical 14 points. As we see, Ninjas in Pyjamas is slightly favored in this best of 3. Here's Flaren watching the middle. Does not get the pick. Zemphis watching it as well. Interesting, Molotov. A lot of times Cloud9 has been successful on this map against Ninjas in Pyjamas. Not in this game is when they push long. Ninjas in Pyjamas has not been allowing them to do that this time. Alright, Cloud9 sitting up. Again for this A take. It's all up to if they can flash out Flaren here and take the site. The retake is what they've been struggling with. They really need a lurk player. With Shroud dead already, they don't have an extra player to spare. Hiko's gonna play lurk. But he hasn't really been stopping the players from lurking. A good place to play this, because what we've seen happen is the CTs rotate into CT so quickly, is maybe play up here at mid, then move in here and take him from behind. But they're not doing that. Instead, Hiko gonna be pushing at long. Already planting the bomb without firing a shot. Get Right watching the corner. Get Right versus Hiko once again. And this time Get Right gets it. Gare's going long as well. Interesting. Nothing waiting for these players at CT. 3 players CT, just like before. In the meantime, here comes Gare's. And he catches Flaren off guard. Nothing trying to hold them down. Oh, and they both do go down. And Ninjas in Pyjamas takes it, puts it into a 15 against 10. Now Cloud9. Now is the time. Now it's crunch time. Pressure's on. Force buy. Activate. And there it is. Hiko won't be able to buy a gun. He'll probably just get armor and a pistol. Oh, he actually gets a Galil with no helmet. So that's good enough. 2 Galils. It's a buy. It's something. No nades and flashes. Here it goes. They're going to try their patented pushing long A. Exist is completely in a daze there. Puts him down to 13 health. They are commencing with this. Boosting a player up. I like this. This is a strong hold off at long. So they've sort of not continued to push here. Taking their time. They think there's a player pit, but guess what? There is not. Instead, they are inside of long A here. This is match point now for the Ninjas in Pyjamas. Nice pick by Flaren taking out Hiko. That's not an easy shot. Alright. That's the first blood spilled, though. Terrorist took long without a shot. Nothing is playing lurk. And Get Right takes him down. Zemph is sneaking up on the side. Where's the smoke? Shroud has it, but they're not smoking the cross. There it is. It's a little bit off the... Whoa! Zemph with the pick on Get Right. Giving bomb site here to these tees. 3 versus 3 retake going to favor Cloud9. How did Ninjas in Pyjamas let this slip through their fingers as Cloud9 took long A? Two players at short for the retake. Here's Gears watching it from inside of the site. Two players from pit. Bomb planted for long. This is very difficult to deal with as a CT. Does it even matter, though? Gears holding it off, and Semphis from pit. Wow. Cloud9, an excellent hold off, keeping them in this game. Well, 4 more in a row here for Cloud9 to put it into an overtime. Try to win this thing 2-0 against Ninjas in Pyjamas. Of course, just 1 round left for Ninjas in Pyjamas to win. They have 4 rounds to use to get 1, so they're going to use this one as a save. Forrest, even though he has 5,000, just purchasing the CZ. Alright. Ooh, Freiburg gets into lower B. This is scary. They gotta check their corners. Check your corners. Check your corners. He didn't check his corners. That will give a gun here to Freiburg. So far, not going very well for Cloud9. Freiburg says, okay, they're going A. Everybody rotate. Here comes Forrest to rotate. In the meantime, terrorists have already pushed forward at long. Taking the site. We'll be able to get this bomb down. Bomb's still way far behind. Get right, gonna try and flank. This is a pistol round. Should be a sure win here for Cloud9. But Ninjas in Pyjamas, okay positioning. Forrest trying to jump CZ as a player plants the bomb. Shroud's having none of that. Aborts the plant. He can't plant. This player is jumping up and taking him every time. Now boosting Freiburg up. They finally get it planted safe. And two players left. Just going to have pistols. Get right. That was nice. Takes out Hiko there at car. Ooh. But gets punished. 1 versus 2. Match point. Fuflaren. No armor. USP. Probably not going to happen. And there's the death. Alright, Ninjas in Pyjamas has 3 rounds to win it. They went for that. That was crazy. They've got plenty of money to make it happen in this round. Not enough for an AWP, though. And Fafleran really wants an AWP. He could go AWP no armor. No, instead he's just going to use M4. He's been doing really well with the AWP on this half, though. Getting a few of those critical shots. Ninjas in Pyjamas aggressively smoking there to take long position. Get players into the pit. Terrorists creeping forward at, middle right now. CT's rotating back. This is match point, guys. And Fafleran smokes them off, so they're probably gonna be like, nope, 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 nope. Or is this a yes? Is this a yes? Is it a yes? I think it's a yes. It's a yes! Terrorists pushing out! At long A, taking the site. All 5 of them still up, just 3 counter terrorists left, and again Cloud9 is able to abuse bomb site A. They have it. Now CTs move in for the retake. No, they're going to be saving all across the map. Wow, excellent job. Semphis there watching long. That was a nice take. And T's gonna be sending out their assassination squad. Here is Gidright. That's not where you want to jump, Semphis. Gidright being aggressive. If CT's save here completely, they'll be able to buy next round. Oh, Gidright goes down. There's no reason to really hurt the economy of Cloud9. They only have to win 1 round. And Cloud9 is going to be able to buy no matter what. So, there's no reason to hurt the economy of Cloud9. Saving get right instead of going for that pick may have been a better decision. All right, 2 rounds left to win it here. Cloud9 could push this into an overtime. 2-player buy, Forrest and Freiburg, or they saved those from last round. Ninjas in Pyjamas using this as another save round. Ooh, that's not good. Oh, I like this position by Forrest. Oh, but Hiko completely aware of it. He's taken down to 22. 2 players left here. Semphis in a forward position. Yeah, you only get 1 clip with that, bro. He does go down. We get 2 magazines, but it empties very quickly. Oh, for flaring. Watching for gears. That's not gonna happen. Exist. 1 versus 4. In the smoke. Trying to survive for the next round. which should be a buy round, because it is last round, round 30. Ninjas and pajamas. Nice. No reason to do that, though, but it was pretty cool. Shroud moving in. And he takes down two players with him. Let's actually see if that did anything here, moving into the last round. If we check out the economy at the start of this. Two ops saved here. Two ops T-side. No, I mean, look at that. Cloud9 can buy whatever they want on this round. They can afford to get auto snipers and spam middle at the start of this if they want to. But guess what? Match point again. It's either going to be an overtime, or it's going to be a 16-14. Which is crazy. Forrest jumps by, avoids the shot. Nice pick by Faflaren, a critical frag. Now puts it into a 5 versus 4 holdoff. Two player stack inside B. Cloud9 has not really been very aggressive at B. They sort of focused on A and abusing those positioning by Ninjas and Pajamas. Nothing gonna smoke mid to B, and I think they're gonna go mid to B. I think that's the strand here. All the terrorists at middle. Yeah, they're gonna all push out mid to B. Let's see if Exist can spray them down. Oh, smoke is not perfect. Well, there's a few more. Exist charging through it, though. Hiko waiting for him. Ooh, takes him down. Forrest still up inside of the site, though. Kills nothing with a Molotov. And we now have a 3 versus 2 match point. Retake. It's pretty even at this point. Could go either way at this point. Two players for mid. One from the tunnels, that's Forrest. T's have to keep aware of this. Hiko playing in sight. Gares in an exposed position right to the left here. Forrest is making noise. Gares could catch him off guard. No, never mind. Just Hiko left. One versus three, and Faflaren will get the game-winning frag. There's the defuse. Ninjas in Pajamas at 16-14, pushing this into a game three. What a great game. What a great matchup between these two teams. That was close. Could have gone either way. Thank you folks very much for watching. I am the War Owl. There's going to be an annotation link to game number 3. And I still have no closer.